Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA.
And liftoff of OSIRIS-REx.
On September 8th, NASA launched the Origin's Spectral Interpretation Resource Identification Security Regolith Explorer, or OSIRIS-REx mission from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station in Florida. OSIRIS-REx, the first U.S. mission to sample an asteroid, is scheduled to arrive at near-Earth asteroid Bennu in 2018. Mission plans call for the spacecraft to survey the asteroid, retrieve a small sample from its surface, and return the sample to Earth for study in 2023. Analysis of that sample is expected to reveal clues about the history of Bennu over the past 4.5 billion years, as well as clues about the evolution of our solar system. Expedition 48 Commander Jeff Willams of NASA closed out a record-breaking tour aboard the International Space Station when he and cosmonauts Alexei Ovchinin and Oleg Skripochka of the Russian space agency Roscosmos departed the station on September 6th. This was the end of Willams' third long-duration tour aboard the station and upped his total number of days in space to 534. Both are records for an American astronaut. The crew landed safely several hours later in Kazakhstan after spending 172 days conducting research aboard the station. Meanwhile, the next crew headed to the ISS, Expedition 4950, which includes NASA's Shane Kimbrough, continues its pre-launch activities. Kimbrough, cosmonauts Sergei Ryzhikov and Andrei Borisenko, and the members of the backup crew participated in traditional ceremonies in Star City, Russia on September 8th. Afterward, they departed for the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan to complete final training for the launch of Kimbrough, Ryzhikov, and Borisenko on September 23rd Eastern Time for a five-month mission on the International Space Station. For the second year in a row, a team of engineering students from West Virginia University won the Level 2 competition of NASA's Sample Return Robot Challenge at Worcester Polytechnic Institute in Massachusetts. The team earned $750,000 in prize money by successfully navigating its robot to retrieve the most simulated samples in the timed competition. NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden was on hand to congratulate the team. The annual event provides an opportunity for citizens to help NASA address problems that might be encountered on future deep space exploration missions. An update on NASA's future all-electric X-57 aircraft named Maxwell. Weeks after arriving at aerospace company Scaled Composites in Mojave, California, the agency's first X-plane in a decade has reached a new milestone. Maxwell's wing was integrated with its fuselage, bringing the X-57 closer to its final Phase 2 configuration. Next, work on the motor mounts and battery systems will continue the process of converting the Technam P2006T into NASA's first fully electric X-plane featuring distributed electric propulsion. This design aims to demonstrate flight that is cruise efficient, quieter, and more environmentally friendly, all key elements in NASA's new Aviation Horizons initiative. NASA's Glenn Research Center in Cleveland highlighted new aviation ideas and technologies during the second annual Convergent Aeronautics Solution Showcase on September 7th. The event featured work by NASA researchers dedicated to pushing the boundaries of aviation and achieving new capabilities in aeronautics. The most promising of the technologies and concepts will be considered for further development by NASA aeronautics programs or by direct transfer to the aviation community. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.